Warning. Viewing of this program has been shown to cause permanent brain damage in laboratory animals. You should consult your physician before attempting to view any of the program material.
Deep beneath the surface of the Metroplex, there is a gigantic industrial complex known as the Fillmore. Built as part of a nationwide chain of underground vaults in the 1930s, the Fillmore...
This program has been shown to cause permanent brain damage in laboratory animals. You should consult your physician before attempting to view any of the program material.
Deep beneath the surface of the Metroplex, there is a gigantic industrial complex known as the Fillmore. Built as part of a nationwide chain of underground vaults in the 1930s, the Film Vault is used to preserve and protect America's fast motion picture libraries. Staffed by brave men and women, trained in this highly specialized skill, America's Film Vaults are judged by the highest standards of the Texas 27 Film Vault. Join us now as our Film Vault techs, Randy and Richard, bring you another classic feature from the Texas 27 Film Vault.
Tonight we're showing none other than They Saved Hitler's Brain. This Hitler comes to us courtesy of Joe Riley, a special effects artist here in the Dallas-Fort Worth area.
I am sick to my stomach.
And, hey, it's good to have you here, Adolf.
My snail!
That isn't even funny. Now you're being... This is terrible. I don't think they deserve this. They deserve better.
You're
they
gonna
deserve
love
first
this.
Quality.
No, you're going to love this movie tonight. Hitler's Brain. Actually, they don't save just Hitler's brain. They save his whole head.
Oh, no.
Yeah, they do. They put it in this little glass case, and he goes...
My snail!
Just like
no.
That. That's his only line in the whole thing. Right now, Amadeus is big, right?
Rock Me Amadeus?
Yeah, Rock Me Amadeus.
By Falco?
Yeah, they do.
Amadeus.
Yeah. Why not something about the Hitler rap or something like that?
The Hitler rap?
I know it's in bad taste, but can you imagine it for a moment?
No.
Man, get a grip on yourself.
I don't like this.
Watch your corners.
Man, I smell a rat, man.
Oh, great time for humor, okay?
Okay. Which way?
That way. Which? Okay.
Corridor. Here we go.
All right.
What's going on?
Come over here. Come over here.
Look.
What?
Watch out, man. Anything could happen.
There's a rat here.
Hey, look out!
Man. Oh, man, that thing's... What is it, man?
Wait.
It's just
a type B!
Yeah,
Hey, man, it's the Big Mama, man!
It's your daddy, man!
Man, what's happening? Look, man! Check it out!
He's still alive!
What? What are you gonna do?
I'm sorry, we gotta save the guy.
We gotta save him.
Just quiet. Get the incinerator ready. We're gonna flank him.
Okay.
We're gonna flank him, right?
Okay. You take the lead, man. I'm going.
All right.
Let's go! Okay!
This is happening to me. I don't have the guns ready. Where's Randy anyway? Oh, hi, everybody. Welcome, really welcome to the Texas 27 Film Vault. I'm sorry, I'm pacing around like a crazy man. You just don't understand. First of all, we've got great entertainment tonight, okay? As usual, a great feature. We've got Queen of Blood starring John Saxon and Dennis Hopper, a classic motion picture. Not only that, we have got the winner of our contest, Debbie Soper Upchurch, the winner of our contest, Why I Want to Be a Film Ball Technician, you know? The people that wrote it, well, she's here tonight. Randy is up on another level with her, and they're getting ready to drive down in their little subterranean vehicle. But I don't know where they are, and I'm going nuts. Because, first of all, the Uzis are supposed to be down here. They're not down here. First of all, the LTC is on the blink. I don't know what to do about that. Not only that, all the materials that I'm supposed to show her tonight are nowhere to be found because they're supposed to be here. And not only that, I don't even have the film up on the... I mean, the reels aren't even on the projector. And I got... And what... Oh, hi, sir. What's... You smell a little funny. Commando Car... You, but not only... He's been hitting the sauce. Get it together, Commando! Hey, it's all right, buddy. You know, this guy's really been getting on my nerves. Nice guy. Yes, sir. Well, say hi to the people, Commando. Yeah, I never can say a damn word in edgewise. Commando, are you about ready to show another exciting chapter of Radar Men for the Moon? He's ready. Well, let's roll it, you drunk. We'll be back in a minute. Well, there you have it, another exciting chapter of Radar Men for the Moon. Took the words right out of my mouth. Boy, I wonder what's going to happen next. Boy, I tell you, you know, you're something else. You know that? You're really that. You know, but there's something you ought to know. Now, you can't really, you shouldn't take off. No, wait. Now, you should never drink and fly. Are you sure you can handle that? You're sure? All right. Okay, you're the superhero. You know it all. Well, happy trails to you. All right. Take it easy there. Oh, my. Well, gee, he kind of hurt. Well, for a sot, he's not a bad guy, but I told him about drinking and flying. Oh, Randy! There he is! Hey, Randy! Randy, come on, go! Rick! Oh,
What? What did I run over?
Well, Randy, I'm afraid you have just squashed Commando Cody.
Has he been drinking again?
Been hitting the jet fuel.
Hey, no time for that. Guess who we've got here in the Texas 27 Film Vault? We have the winner of our Why I Want to Be a Film Vault Technician contest, Debbie Soper Upchurch from Arlington, Texas.
And this is an exciting occasion.
Yes, it is. Once you shake her hand, Richard.
Okay.
There you go.
Can I kiss it?
Oh, yeah, go ahead. I guess that's all right. We've got a big evening planned for Debbie here. We want you to stay tuned for Queen of Blood.
Yes.
And we're also going to be showing Debbie the ins and outs of being a film vault technician. Are you ready, Debbie?
Sure.
You sure?
I'm ready.
You're ready?
Yeah.
You sure?
Sure. Okay.
Good. We're going to go to a break. Be back with her training in just a moment.
Oh, would you quit your sniveling? That's all you seem to do anymore, snivel. You've been sniveling for 2 hours. What is this? Oh, that's terrible. Gee, I'm really upset. Oh, hi, everybody. Welcome to the Texas 27 Film Vault. It's me, Richard. Randy's not around. I got to listen to sniveling snot nose over here. Sot. Superhero. Big. What is your deal? Just shut up, Randy. We're showing Tales from the Crypt. I know I'm in a bad mood. I'm just kind of upset and got to listen to this crying. But what? Okay, now tell me what the problem is. You've been doing this for the last 2 hours. Well, I'll translate for you. Apparently, Commando Cody's wife has left him. I'll get a grip. It's not the end of the world. Besides, you're drowning yourself in this stuff again. I've told you about that. You want to get run over again? You don't need any more of that. I have told this man 1,000 times. Stay off the sauce. Will he do it? No. Now, you don't need it. You don't need it. Now, forget it. So your wife's gone. Big deal. So you got problems. You think you got problems? No, you don't have problems. Let me tell you a problem. But I got problems of my own, you know? Well, let me tell you. I'm kind of upset tonight. It's a big night for me. I'll tell you why. It's my birthday. Where is everyone? I'm stuck down here with this drunk of a superhero, big brave. Would you get rid of them? What is it with you? Leave them stuff alone. Listen to my problems. I mean, listen, you bawl and squall for the last half. Okay, now just listen. It's my birthday. Is anybody here? No. You see anybody here? You see any party favors or birthday cake or your friends and chums and patting you on the back and shaking your hand? And... No, they're not here. You know why? You know why they're not here? Because they don't like me. They don't like me. My buddy Randy, he gets everything. Do I get anything? Do I get an Uncle Leaf Guster? Do I get a birthday party? Do I get the girls? No, I don't get nothing. You know why? Because they don't like me. Well, I'll tell you something. I don't care if I ever see them again. Ever, ever, ever again. I'm mad.
What is this? This is great. Oh, this is wonderful. Ah, oh, you guys are great. This is great. Hey, oh, look. Why, oh, I don't know what to say. Inspector, you here? That's Murdoch. I don't believe it.
Bobby Murray.
Yeah, how you doing? This is great. Oh, this is wonderful. This is good.
Oh.
Come on. Listen, you guys. I guess I can make a speech. You know, first of all, I just want to say, of all the friends in the world, you guys are the very best. You hear what I'm saying? And you guys, I knew all along that you guys wouldn't let me down, because I'm your friend, right? The best friends in the world. We're having a party. I got a cake. All my friends are here. Hey, I got a great idea. While we're having a party, why don't we watch the next exciting chapter of Radar Men for the Moon, starring Commando Cody. Hey! And it's seen the ruin of many a poor boy. And God, I know I'm one. What a chorus! Hey, we're partying out here in the Texas. This is so much fun. This is so much fun. My birthday party. Thanks a lot, guys. But wait a minute.
What?
Somebody's missing. Where's Randy? Randy's got to be here. Well, I want to know where Randy is.
Hey, everybody.
He's got to be here somewhere.
Hey, how you doing?
Randy!
Hey,
it's good to see you, buddy.
It's good to see you again. Hey, everybody, how you doing?
Hey, Randy's here, everybody.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Just a second, guys. I'll be back. Hey, Randy.
Listen, I'm sorry to pull you away from the party. I'm sorry.
Thanks for the party. This
you're
is great.
Very welcome.
Oh, I'm having so much fun.
I hope you're having a good time. I planned this thing for weeks, and I hope
you did a good job, I got to tell you.
But unfortunately, on the night of your party, I'm very, very sorry to announce. The reason I was late, I was down on level 72 on the east corridor in the storage area, big storage area.
What were you doing down there?
Cellulites. We've got cellulites crawling all over the place, slime. They're eating film left and right. They're going through a bunch
They're going
through some very rare Vincent Price film.
Not the VP
film. I'm sorry, but they are.
This can't be having on my birthday.
Hey, all you film vault technicians out there that don't know what a cellulite is, let me tell you very quickly. As you can see here in my biology book, a cellulite, nasty little guys here.
Yeah, they're nasty.
They grow from either 2 inches to 2 feet in length.
Yeah, and when they're that long, they can really cause them damage.
Yes, they can. They can chew right through acres of film stock.
Just what we need.
They feed on celluloid. They are sometimes, in other areas of the country, a bigger threat than rats. But usually in Texas, they don't give us much of a problem. We don't give them a second thought, but all of a sudden now they are infesting.
Why? Why is that?
I don't know. I guess it's the weather or something, but they are coming out in droves, and I really think that some of our preliminary dustings that we did last year, they weren't enough, and it's time for another one very soon.
Well,
I know I
did a good job last time, so maybe you better get after it.
No, actually, I was hoping that you would volunteer, since it is your turn.
I did it last time, Randy.
No, you didn't, Richard.
You have a foggy memory,
I'm telling you right now that November the 15th of last year was the last time I flew the prop
That's
pack.
Exactly right. And then shortly thereafter, in January, I flew it the next time.
No, I'm sorry.
No,
you
I did.
Not.
Yes, I did.
I don't remember that.
I was busy for 2.5 hours.
Richard, you mean you're not going to take at least 2 hours out of your party, which I helped plan, to go down there and spray for the cellulites?
It's your turn. Don't try to get out of it.
Richard, I hate flying the prop pack.
I know you hate flying, but
it's a dirty job.
And you're going to do it. Now, you've been flying for 5 years. I think you can handle it. Why don't we just get to it here?
Multi-quixie filing, the dust we use smells like rotten eggs, and I hate that job.
You can take a shower. You can take a shower.
And I don't like to fly.
Look, we got a lot of things to do here. Would you get with it?
Okay, we're going to take a break, and I'll tell you what, if I'm going to fly the prop pack tonight while you party, I want some of those guys to help me launch.
We'll take care of it. Don't worry about
it.
All right. Okay? Just get a grip of yourself.
You sure it's my turn?
It's your turn.
Ah.
It's going on tomorrow.
Are you kidding?
No, it's going to be from 11 to 4, and Vincent's going to be there, and Ivy's going to be there.
How much does it cost?
It's cheap. $4.50.
I'm going there.
Yeah, we're going to have a great... Be sure and go out there. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Can we leave, man?
Oh, yeah, we'll do that. You know, I got to tell you something, Mr. Ganther. I got to tell you something. You know, I conned Randy into pulling the prop pack duty. It was a con job. It was really my turn. Now he's up there and he's... Oh, I got something coming in. Randy? Yeah, hi. You ready? You're launching here?
Roger. I'm launching now from the pad.
Well, how's it going up there?
About 10 meters up. Going to head up to level 34. Bouncing down to 74B on the lower side there, on the east wing of the vault.
Yeah, well, do a great job, okay?
Terrific, terrific. Okay.
That's funny.
Isn't that great?
You're
hey, well,
fired.
Hey, yeah. No, I'm not fired. No, we're going to show Tales from the Crypt. It's coming up. Yeah. So. Oh, boy. Oh, that's.
Oh,
I hate
God.
That. Yeah?
Yeah.
Good.
Hey, good,
I'm glad. You're getting the dust, huh? Good. Well, listen, you got a long way to go. Okay, good. Just get the job done. Cause, man, you got to go a long way. So, dust, boy, dust. Get that work done. Okay? Go on.
Okay.
Randy's up there dusting for cellulite. We got him everywhere. You know, it's a crazy mess. He's got the prop bag on, and he's got him flying around doing his thing. We're having a big party here. Well, what's going on? Listen, it really was my turn to dust. But I figured since it was my party, I had to con a guy, and, you know, he's a big fella, and he knows how to fly that thing real good. He's been flying for a long time. So he's up there dusting for cellulite. We're having a great time. We are watching Tales from the Crypt, starring Peter Cushing and Joan Collins, that lovely lady, my lover. Wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. It's time for my favorite part of the show. It's time for the mystery film clip with lovely Laurie. Yo, Laurie! Laurie! Laurie?
Oh, excuse me. There's not enough air in here as it is, and then Randy decides to fly by with this little contraption he's got hooked on his back. Oh, the thing stinks. So, how you doing today? Got a lot of answers this week. Let's go back to last week's film clip, see if you can guess it again. Well, it's time to pick my winner. Sorry, you know what happens to the rest of you. Anyway, the answer was This Island Earth, starring I forget who. But anyway, the winner is James Newfield of Mesquite. Congratulations, you now own Film Vault T-shirts, the red one. Nice postcard, I like that. Let's get to this week's. We're going to stump you again. We're going to make it harder and harder each week. So if you think you can get it this time, once again, there's the address. Write me. I'll be waiting. Hey, by the way, I'm kind of upset with the Metroplex out there. For 3 weeks, I've had these puppies, okay? I finally got them. Does anybody congratulate me? No. Well, forget it. I'm going to a birthday party. There's a lot of guys up there. Some of them good looking. But then again, I've been in the vault so long, it doesn't matter what they look like. We'll see you later.
Boy, we're having a great day. We're having a birthday party. We're throwing tails in the crypt. I got cake, what's left of it, and everybody's having a party.
Yay!
Hey, Randy, I can hear him. Wait, where is it? Hey, Randy? Hey, everybody. Randy's coming in for a landing.
All right, bring it in. Slow it down a little bit. Throttle back. Okay, lean over here for a second. Okay, that should do it. Am I hooked up?
Thanks a lot, guys. Yeah. With friends like you, who needs enemies, huh?
Listen.
What's wrong? Where's everybody going?
Everybody's fine. Listen, I'm going to be back in a minute.
Yeah, listen, you stay right here.
Wait a minute. I don't want to. You stay.
I'm missing out on the party that I planned. I can't believe this, because it's your turn to actually be on the prop pack duty.
Yeah, right. I know it is. Look, could you do me a favor? Could you stand a little further over there? You really smell.
Oh, of course I stink. I've got multi-quixie filing dust all over me. How about you?
Oh, don't cry,
yeah,
baby.
Have a little bit. Have
no,
a little
I
bit.
Want, get out of way. You stink.
Yeah, you made me a social outcast because you didn't want to fly the prop pack.
It wasn't my turn. Now, we discussed this earlier.
Okay, all right. I'm going to go back. I've got two more levels to do. It's going to take me the rest of the night. I'm not going to be able to see Tales from the Crypt like everybody else out there, but I landed because I want to be here for this week's secret decoder message. We've got some new rules, and I don't think you can remember how.
Okay, let's see who else we got in.
Read some more from Cartoon Babylon. I want to hear what happened to some of the cartoon characters
this
throughout
is just,
my
yeah,
childhood.
This is incredible. You're not going to believe this. Okay, everybody's heard of Strawberry Shortcake.
She's kind of recent.
Yeah, she's a recent, you know, kind of a thing.
Yeah.
She's a doll that millions of girls all over America love.
Oh, here's the lowdown on Strawberry
Get
Shortcake.
Ready for this, okay? You're not going to believe it. One of the newest and most popular cartoon heroines to emerge in recent years, Strawberry Shortcake's budding career could have been ruined were it not for the suppression of reports that she is known as the
easiest girl in Hollywood.
Ooh.
In a movie capital, tales of her sexcapades are legion. And even jaded, long time, Hollywood insiders express shock at her outrageous promiscuity. At one infamous party, she reportedly made love to the entire cast of Gandhi. That's incredible.
Wow.
Still, her career has taken off, and she is preparing for her third film role, starring with her close friend, My Little Pony, in a movie about the life of Catherine the Great.
Ooh.
That's incredible.
Boy. Yeah, read on.
Yeah, this is really neat. Remember Yosemite Sam?
Yosemite Sam, the guy
crazy,
going
crazy guy, yeah. Okay, now get this.
Okay.
The irascible gun-toting cowboy who played Bugs Bunny's nemesis in many classic Warner Brothers cartoons was reported to be as nasty off-screen as he was on.
Hmm.
As if to prove this point, he was arrested by L.A. police in 1969 for aggravated assault with a deadly weapon after drawing two six-shooters and blazing away at Chasen's restaurant's head waiter after a dispute over the $257 bill. That Yosemite Sam is something. You know what I'm talking about? Sam was convicted and served 10 years in the California State Penitentiary. After his release, he was ordered to undergo psychiatric testing at the Inglewood Sanitarium and was later committed to that institution.
Poor Yosemite
Sam. A sad lot.
Yeah.
Well, there's more. Now, get this. Sylvester. Remember the pussycat Sylvester? Crazy.
Oh, I thought I saw a pussycat.
Yeah, that guy. Yeah, between.
Whatever happened to him?
Okay, here's what happened. Known for his exasperated, suffering, succotash line in dozens of Warner Brothers cartoons, Sylvester was accused of eating Tweety Pie during a scandalous court battle
in
the early 70s. He ate him. Yeah, I can't believe it. The feline pleaded not guilty and was acquitted. After supposedly incriminating stomach x-rays, disappeared from prosecutor Raymond Perry's office.
Mm-hmm.
In 1982, Sylvester was treated for catnip addiction at the Betty Ford Drug and Alcohol Rehabilitation Center, and he has also served as spokescat for the POW, it says Pussycats of War League. Incredible. And
wow.
You heard it right here in the Texas 27 film.
Yes, right here in this book, Cartoon Babylon. And we're going to let you have the lowdown on Betty Boop in just a little while, so stay with us, okay?
Back to the movie, okay?
Heaven Film Ball.
I hate these things. Of course we got to have them. Why do they clean them? I don't even know what I'm doing. Oh, of course I know what I'm doing. I know how to handle a weapon. I know how to handle... Hi, everybody, I'm Richard with the Texas 27 Film Vault. We're here again. Aren't you excited? Everybody's excited. The drones are excited. I'm crazy. Of course, my pal Randy isn't here. Well, we've got a great movie tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Bela Lugosi, starring in Bowery at Midnight. And Randy's going to be up in a minute. He's cataloging downstairs. And ladies and gentlemen, our resident superhero, Commando Cody. Boy, what in the world are you doing? Oh, let me tell him. What he's trying to tell us is, yes, we showed a wonderful movie last week, Invasion of the Star Creatures, which I personally like. But, of course, well, maybe it was a bit of a stinker. I don't know. So that's why you're spraying you have a funny sense of humor. Well, anyway, hey, we've got another exciting chapter of Commando Cody in, what's it called? Say that again. You know, after a while, you get to kind of knowing what he's saying. He said, another exciting chapter of Radar Men from the Moon. That's it. How do you do that? Radar Men from the Moon. Roll it. Another exciting chapter, Commando Cody and Radar Men from the Moon. Unfortunately, our friend has left. The superhero had chores to take care of, you know, since his wife and kids left.
Okay, how's that?
Oh, hey. Hi. Oh, he's back. Good. Mr. Randy Clower of the Film Vault, the other half.
A little cataloging to do. My arm's a little stiff still. But,
oh, don't give me that.
Feeling pretty good.
Well, I'm glad to hear that.
I'm looking forward to tonight's movie. I know you are.
Oh, it's going to be a classic. Bela Lugosi, Bowery at Midnight.
One of my favorite actors of all time, Bowery at Midnight. I'm going to enjoy myself tonight. I've got all our work completed.
Yes.
And I'm going to sit here and I'm going to watch this movie, have a good time, and eat my lunch.
Well, I think it's about time you did eat some lunch.
I think so.
You work pretty hard.
I have been working pretty hard.
You know what else
we're going to do tonight, Richard?
What are we going to do tonight?
We are going to give away a stereo TV receiver.
Well, it's just about time.
Excuse me, fellas.
Wait, I don't know how you got in here, but you have to go through the channels and everything.
Why does this always happen?
It's okay. I took care of everything. My name's Felix Swansea. I am the president and founder of the Dallas chapter for the exhumation, preservation, and resurrection of Bela Lugosi. Perhaps you've heard of us.
No, I haven't heard of it.
Oh, well.
And I don't know who you are, what your organization stands for, but you do have to
It stands for Mr. Lugosi. You see, Mr. Lugosi, one of the greatest actors to ever grace the American motion picture screen.
Right.
Why?
And,
why does this always happen?
I don't understand.
I want to have
this
a quiet evening in the vault and watch a good movie and crazy.
We're going to come down to the drones. That's it. All we're going to go.
Do you have a visitor's pass or anything?
No,
you don't.
I paid $5 ahead to get in.
Well, okay.
Well, and I have
to. It's okay.
Yeah,
it's okay. I can stay.
For $5, sure.
Come on, fellas! Wait.
I thought it was just... Wait. Now, you don't understand.
No, you said you.
You said it was just you.
What?
Why
is this?
Yeah, well, what's going on?
That's my...
Well, wait a minute. Wait. Randy, they're taking my hat.
Well, who are these people?
They?
I don't have this thing loaded. Come in. Oh, come on. I fixed it. Randy, this communicator won't work.
Quiet.
Quiet. You heard him. He said quiet.
I don't know why this is. I wanted a quiet evening and eat my lunch
and watch a good movie tonight here in the film hall.
All of a sudden crazy people come down the staff again. Crazy people.
Listen, who are you and what is this all about?
These are members of the Dallas chapter for the exhumation, preservation, and resurrection of Bela Lugosi, otherwise known as the Bat Pack.
Wait,
like a Bela Lugosi fan club? Is that what it is?
More than a Bela Lugosi fan club.
More than a Bela Lugosi fan club.
More than is a Bela Lugosi worship organization.
Randy, this is incredible. Do you realize who's in our vault tonight?
A bunch of crazy people who worship Bela Lugosi.
We are here tonight to summon Bela back from the grave.
Bela back from the grave. Randy, this is incredible.
No, you're not going to
wait a minute. No. We've got to do it. This is a dream of a lifetime.
Get your hands off my neck.
I'm sorry.
I don't like this. I think everybody should leave.
I think it's a great idea.
I'm friendly.
Look at this guy. He's eating my food. Don't eat all this food. Maybe we can have that seance.
Okay.
May I present the Swami Rikardadachi Tamur Shajrish Eptam.
Ah.
He will be...
Swami. Hey.
He will be conducting the service tonight.
Why is it you always fall
for... Sir.
You see, this is the ideal atmosphere. Bela Lugosi's film is being shown, Bowery at midnight, and we are underground where Bela is at this...
Roll the movie. Just roll the movie. We'll take care of it.
Wait a minute.
No.
May I have your attention, Crazy Richard?
Be quiet, Randy. He's getting ready to do the seance.
I must have complete quiet.
Complete quiet.
Now, in order to reach Bela Lugosi, I must go into the crystal ball. Pardon me.
Surely.
Hey, buddy. Think you could plug this in for me?
Yeah, sure. Okay. Swami.
Thank you very much.
Now,
everyone here to place their hands upon these cans and touch them together to reach Bela, we must have it this way. All right. Are there any special requests before we...
Do you think I can get an autograph?
Oh, certainly. If you've got a pen on your buddy, put it right here.
Okay.
Now, everyone, close your eyes. Lower your heads. Penso che sogno cos non dare torne ma più. Me ne venge con le mani le pace. Poi di proviso tenido dal veneto rapito. Volare. Oh.
Hey. We're resurrecting Bela Lugosi, not Dean Martin.
Oh, I'm sorry. I got the sidetracked.
Hey, buddy, you unplugged it. Come on.
Randy, don't do that. He can't do his Swami thing. Now you're messing it all up.
You, Sonia, I must have quiet, complete.
Right back with more of Texas 27's Film Vault. Right after this.
You know, I've seen Richard go off the deep end many, many times in the Texas 27 Film Vault, but allowing this group of lunatics to conduct a seance in our break area on a night when I wanted to relax and watch Bela Lugosi in Bowery at midnight. They're conducting a seance in order to get in touch with Bela Lugosi. This is without a doubt the most stupid thing that Richard has ever done, without a doubt. I can't think of anything else that could be more stupid. All I can say is I hope Lori hasn't fallen under the spell of the Swami. Lori, give us a mystery film clip, something normal.
Hi, how's everybody doing tonight? Good, I hope.
What do you think of Richard's idea, huh? I thought it was a pretty good one, trying to get this Swami guy to bring Bella around. I'd like to meet him. Spooky character. You know I like people like that. Anyway, business at hand. We kind of stumped us last week because I only had one entry. For you, unfortunately, it's wrong. Let's see if we can get it this time. Try it again.
I'll help you.
Okay, so I'm going to give you another chance. I don't want this thing to go on weekly. Somebody's got to get the answer. Usually y'all get it or nobody gets it. Figure yourselves out, will you? This is my address. You know where I am. Write me. I'll be waiting for you.
Richard and Randy in attending the first annual Ben Johnson, Bubba Berry Celebrity Team Roping and Cutting Horse Competition Sunday, June 8th at Will Rogers Memorial Center in Fort Worth, Texas. Get to meet over 50 famous movie stars. 12 noon autograph session, 2 p.m. celebrity rodeo. The proceeds to benefit the Ben Johnson Bubba Berry Ranch for Abused Children. For more information, telephone Fort Worth 817-332-2765 or Dallas 214-357-8987.
This is just incredible. Hi, everybody. Of course, you know we're watching Bowery at Midnight, starring Bela Lugosi, and what a film it is. But the most important thing about tonight, we have the Swami here. We are trying to raise Bela Lugosi from the grave, a la seance. So everyone out there, join hands. What the seance wish. Close your eyes and concentrate.
Bela!
Yes.
Bela!
What's happening, Swami?
He's here with us.
Where is he?
No! Bela! Bela!
Bela!
Bela!
Bela! Bela! Bela! Bela! Bela! Bela! Bela! Bela! Bela! Bela! Bela! Bela! Bela!
Where'd he go? Where'd he go? I don't understand. It's gone. It's gone.
Swami, what's going on here?
What have you done? You've done something here. There's somebody here.
He threw the coop.
I don't know, but he's here. Something's here. Get in here. I'll tell you what's going on here. It's a sham. I knew it all along. Look at this guy. He was up on one of the overhead girders with a stick and a bat with Bela Lugosi's face on it. You mean that wasn't Bela Lugosi? No, it wasn't. It's this guy, and I have a sneaky suspicion it's the Swami involved in this one.
Oh, no. Yeah. No, not the Swami.
Oh, yeah. I knew it was a sham. I knew it all along.
Sim-salabim.
Get out of here. Take it on the road. Murr! Don't believe
me. Ladies and gentlemen, it had to be done. I had to expose the fraudulent Swami there. We'll get back to the movie here in just a second, and I'm going to have a little talk with Richard. Midnight with Bela Lugosi. I wish I could have seen it, but no, we had to have a seance down here to try to raise the poor, tired spirit of Bela Lugosi. And look what happened. You guys got ripped off. I knew the guy was a cheat. The Swami is a fake.
Well, he looked like a real Swami to me. I mean, how are we supposed to know?
He looked like an old magic act from the 1940s. Let's face facts here.
To think that there was corruption in my organization.
Well, it happens to the best of the organizations out there, let me tell you.
I mean, it happens to the film ball guys a lot.
Yeah, especially when you got Richard working down.
Now, wait just a minute. It wasn't my idea. He came down and he paid $5.
You encouraged him. You said, come on down. We're going to...
We made a lot of money. We made about $75.
Yeah, we had to give it back when they left.
Oh, well.
Okay. Hey, enough of this. Let's get on to some happy subject here.
Okay, let's get happy.
All right. It's time to give away a stereo TV receiver.
Oh, that's a happy thing.
You bet. During the month of May, we've been giving out a secret message for all of you that have your Film Vault decoders. The message was, in what movie did Dennis Hopper play a war photographer? And, of course, that was Apocalypse Now.
Everybody knew that.
Okay?
I didn't know that.
Well, it's true. And we've chosen a winner tonight. That's Carla Ofinger. I think that's how you pronounce it. Carla Ofinger of 510 South Walnut in Cleburne, Texas. You have just won a stereo TV receiver.
That is incredible.
And I guess we're going to be sending it to her or make her walk down here to get it. I don't know.
Why don't you hitchhike and come on down? We'll give it to you. You can hitchhike back. It'll be great.
And next week we're going to be showing what, Richard?
Here we're going to be showing Cauldron of Blood. Cauldron of Blood.
Yeah.
Cauldron of Blood?
Yeah.
With Boris Karloff.
Boris Karloff.
That's right.
The Dallas chapter to for exhumation, preservation, and resurrection of Forrest Carlisle.
No.
That's
no.
a great idea.
No.
We could start a whole organization.
Yeah.
Look, I'll tell you what.
Remember now, safety
I'll
be the president.
Yeah, okay. We can get a real swan.
A real swan.
A real swan.
Wait a minute.
That would be
credits ran over again.
Okay, right, what do we do?
I don't know. We ran out of music.
We'll sing.
It's your turn.
Oh, okay.
Da 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 da. No, wrong.
Oh,
wrong.
Oh, okay. Bum 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 bum.
Vault. Now, what we'll probably have to do here tonight is we'll probably have to set up
this
a key light right over
got,
there.
You're putting dirt.
And then we'll hit him with some really weird
shadows.
What do you think?
Oh, I believe
it.
Yeah, this
is right. Okay, why don't you go over there and get a key light and have it set up right over there.
I know, you're a big
one of the crew guys.
Oh,
thank you. Thank you very much.
Oh, in other words, I won't
Hey, everybody, welcome to the Film Vault tonight. We've got a very special movie for you. We've got Peter Cushing, Christopher Lee in The Mummy, another Hammer horror classic. You probably wonder what's going on here in the vault tonight. Well, I've brought in some very special friends of mine to help me realize a lifelong dream. You may not know this. I'm not just a Film Vault technician. No. I entertain a secret dream of my own, which is to make a major horror movie someday. I've had this script that I've been working on for years, off and on. It's called Scream of the Mummy. Yeah, and I've always wanted to make this into a movie, and so I thought, I'll just get some friends of mine from the Film Vault Academy to come down here, and we'll just do a rehearsal, so to speak. Kind of a screen test, as it were. I've got some very, very fine special effects men here today. Very professional crew members. And...
Here, you need this more than I do, huh?
What? Like I said, these truly are professionals in the motion picture field, and they're going to help me tonight with my mummy extravaganza. And who else but my pal, Ricardo, the talk of the town, to play the lead role.
Randy, one question. Why do you make me do things like this? I don't believe I have gone
wait. Listen,
to do this.
I can't believe that you don't see this as a great opportunity for yourself to advance your career.
See, this is a great opportunity.
Yeah.
This is ridiculous.
The
I can't
lead
even
role
feel my finger.
In my original screenplay, you, the mummy. Can't you see it? It'll be great.
See it? I can't see nothing in this thing. I can't feel nothing.
Well, listen, I remember a time when you had me dress up like a vampire when we did Dr. Blood's coffin.
That makes no difference. You could feel your fingers.
Yeah,
I can't
well,
feel my toes.
Just
I've got dirt on me.
Can't you just be a trooper for me once? This is a dream of mine, a lifelong dream. Can't you just do this without griping?
Okay. Just one thing. I'm not going to forget this. And you owe me one, buddy. Just remember this.
Okay, this seems very, very easy, guys.
Yeah, this is
no
really
problem,
easy.
All right?
Uh-huh. Okay.
You,
okay.
Clarice the Mummy.
Clarice the Mummy?
Yeah, we're going to confront the professor. This is the guy that desecrated your sacred tomb and resurrected you. Right?
Okay, so he's the professor.
Right, yeah, you hate him.
Okay,
you hate
I hate him.
You want to strangle him. You want
No. I want to strangle you.
You.
I want to take my hands.
Yeah,
I want to strangle you.
No, yeah, just this guy, okay?
This is the guy.
All right, okay. Now, you're going to confront the guy. You've broken into his library, right?
I've broken into his library.
And you're going to try and kill him, and he's going to hit you on the head with this bottle. Now, after that,
wait a minute. What do you mean, hit me on the head with a bottle? You didn't say anything about this.
It's in your script. I don't know why you didn't look at it.
I don't care. I'm not getting hit on the head with a bottle. You're a crazy man. I'm not doing it. I dressed up
Richard,
like a mummy, okay?
Calm
I've got
down,
dirt.
Calm.
I can't breathe.
Richard. This is not a real bottle. This is a breakaway bottle, a special effects prop.
What do you mean a break?
It breaks without hurting you. It's not made out of glass. It's made out of special plastic, and it cannot possibly harm you.
You're sure?
They've been using them since the 1920s, okay? It cannot possibly hurt you.
Okay, okay, okay. So I'm the professor. He's desecrated my grave. I have murder
right.
in my eyes. And...
Now, okay, let's do it. Okay, okay. Ready?
So,
yeah, just
okay.
a run through. Okay.
All right. Okay.
All right, here we go.
Okay, here we go.
Action.
Okay, here we go.
Strangle. Okay.
Go. Back. Beautiful. Beautiful.
Excellent. Well done. Well done. Take a break. Great.
You know. Really. You know, I didn't feel anything.
That's great.
That is great. Hey, I didn't
say that.
Great.
Yeah.
Breakaway bottle.
Yeah, breakaway bottles just came in, got them for you, ready to...
Ooh, these are the breakaways.
Yeah.
Well, I'm
gonna...
you're a trooper.
Oh, my...
Yeah, that's pretty interesting stuff there. Yeah, all right. You just about have him ready there?
Yes,
just about?
Yes.
Okay. You know your line. Do you know your line?
Matthew's part of hell.
This is
less
ridiculous. Emotion than that. Okay, you about ready? Okay, we're going to move to the next one here.
Just about ready.
What's your line again?
What is this?
Back, you spawn of hell.
Okay, yeah.
That's pretty good. I like
Randy,
that, yeah.
He's ready.
You ready? Okay, are you ready to do the scene?
Ready to do what scene?
Okay, just stand up here. Come on.
What is this stuff?
Okay, you understand what's happening here? Okay.
I'm a little dizzy.
The archaeologist is desecrating the tomb for the first time, and you're going to see him, and you're going to try to kill him, okay?
I'm going to try to... What?
You're going to try to strangle him. The same old bitch. Just go like that.
I can hardly think. I've got a bump on my head, okay?
He's going to fend you off with a torch.
What? With a torch?
Yeah, the torch.
Wait a minute. What?
Just put your hand out there and go like that. It's perfectly safe. Just go.
Okay.
Randy, very good.
Randy, is this in the script? My hand is on fire. It's torching. Randy, I'm on fire.
Randy, because we have the first secret message for all you Film Vault decoder fans out there. Okay, the very first. If you have a secret decoder, you can win a TV stereo receiver. If you don't. There's still a chance to get a Film Vault decoder and still have a chance to win, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Let's look at this week's mystery film clip.
Okay, but first let's look at last week's mystery film clip.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to repay you for betraying me. I'm going to give that brain of yours a new home in the skull of the Frankenstein monster.
Ooh, that was a tough
one,
wasn't it?
That was very tough, very tough.
Yeah.
I hope we have a winner. Let's check with Sludge and see.
Hey, do we have a clip for this week?
Yes, we do. I've been working real hard while you've been playing with Richard, torturing that poor man like that.
I'm having a great time.
I feel sorry for him. I've been down a level 22, and I dug up a real good one for this week. Let's take a look at it.
You see before you a man who lived for centuries, kept alive by the blood of innocent people. When the full moon rises, I turn into a werewolf with only one desire, to kill.
I tried to perform the miracle of science and failed.
I know that one.
That's a good one, isn't it? If you know that one, write to the address you see on your screen with the answer, and I will pick a winner and send you a Film Vault t-shirt.
Oh, that sounds wonderful.
That? Yeah.
Yes, it does. Well, I think it's time now to go back to torturing Richard some more.
Oh, where
I don't
is he?
See this
He's
as
hiding.
Torture.
I hope you don't find him.
Yeah, well,
I really do.
Wait,
that poor
there
guy.
He is right over there. Hold him.
Hold him. Go, Richard.
Okay, this is a very easy scene.
Oh, this is an easy scene. Don't let me say an attack of Indians. Come get somebody.
No.
They come with arrows, bows and arrows, spears. It's the Roman gladiators.
Well,
this is ridiculous.
I have burns all over my hands.
It's just I've got a lump on my head about as big as a bird's egg.
Come on.
And you want me to do another scene. Forget it,
Richard.
It's over.
Richard.
It's over.
In this scene.
What?
You're supposed to attack a beautiful woman.
Oh, I'm a what? What is it? Some kind of a... Oh, she's beautiful.
Yeah. I thought you might
like
this.
She's really beautiful.
Yeah, see?
She's really a beautiful woman.
I know. I take care of my buddy and my pal.
Oh,
listen, okay, so you've been in the tomb now for about 4,000 years.
Oh, 4,000?
This is the first woman you've seen in that length of time.
I think I get the drift of what you're saying here. No problem. I'll get motivated. I'll show you. I can do this.
I knew you could.
This is a great idea. This is great.
I thought you'd like this. Okay, get ready.
Fine.
Here we go. Okay, so I'm ready.
Everybody,
okay.
Positions, okay?
Okay.
You ready, woman? Oh, I'm really. I'm
excited. Ready to attack her with great ferocity.
Oh, I'm going
to
attack her. Action! Oh no!
With an Uzi submachine gun. It'll be great. I can see it now.
No, Randy.
What?
There's no more scenes.
No.
There are no more scenes. I've had my hand burned tonight. I've been beaten to a pulp. I've also got a giant knot on my head. I've got to go to see a doctor,
This is it. I am fed up.
I ain't doing it, buddy. Forget it.
You're going to let me down? You're going to let me down, your friend of many, many years here, huh?
Yeah, I'm going to let you down, Randy. I'm going to let you way down because I ain't doing nothing for you. You know, and it's funny. I have dreams, too, you know. I have lots of dreams. I've got this great remake in mind, my own remake of a great monster motion picture. It's going to be great. Guys. Take Mr. Randy to makeup. Would you do that for me? You're going to love it, Randy. Yeah, to makeup.
We're going to have a good time, Randy.
To the Mommy and Christopher Lee, Peter Cushing, and oh, I did enjoy it. And one of the great movies you'll see here in the Texas 27 Film Bowl. As you can see, well, it's about time to get out of my gear. You know, Randy was trying to make one of his famous classic movies, and he wanted to make me the mummy. I don't know. Well, I had this great idea. I thought we'd do something with little Randy here, and I call it The Revenge of the Bride of Frankenstein. Take a look at my buddy Randy. Hey, Randy, you look pretty sharp. Thanks, guys.
No problem. I cue you a million times.
Hey, that's not bad. We can use that in the thing. You know, attention, all Film Vault techs. Attention, prepare to receive secret coded trivia questions. First, get a pencil and paper. Now, set your decoder to this week's initial setting. Week.
I don't know.
Without warning, Martin Landau, Jack Palance, it's great fun, it's great excitement, right here in the Texas.
But you won't be here because I'm going to kill you.
No, you're going to kill me.
Oh, yeah, for putting this on me.
Oh, no, no, I think I should kill you. In fact, you know what I'd like to do? I'd like to take a little swing right at your gun.
Nobody. Hey, Dallas Fort Worth. It's another Saturday night, and if you ain't got nobody, then you're watching the Texas 27 Film Vault. The Dallas-Fort Worth television alternative to the singles bars.
I'm Richard, and Randy is about 100 feet below our main break area in ventilator 21B. Nothing to worry about, though. Just some simple maintenance work. Nothing really big time here. Hey, Randolph, how's it going down there?
Yeah, that's fine, Ricardo. Let me change out a few more of these filter grids, and I'll be right up.
Okay, great. Great, okay. Now, tonight, for the enjoyment of our Dallas-Fort Worth film techs, we have dug deep inside one of our forgotten film bins for a feature that could be best described as wretched. The rats are coming, the werewolves are here. Now, we're not sure who made this film, but by the looks of it, it resembles the work of a first-year film student and his buddies at SMU.
Only they've got English accents. I'll bet you this film was made for $40. And not only that, the soundtrack sounds like they recorded it inside the cave out at Six Flags.
You'll also get a kick out of the costume. A mix of early 20th century and Levi's.
There's also some shocking scenes in tonight's movie. First of all, a little mouse gets tortured right there on camera with a hot candle and a knife, and then a chicken gets its neck wrung. Oh, serious, folks, call the ASPCA.
We didn't want to show it, but except we need the ratings.
But before we run, the rats are coming, the werewolves are here. You know what time it is, don't you? Huh? You haven't lived until you've seen the rats are coming, the werewolves are here.
It's proof positive that even the British can make a Plan 9 from outer space every now and then.
Yeah, and they think they're so smart just because they made Gandhi.
And we've got another stab at this month's decoder message and the mystery film clip from Laurie. So put on those helmets and stand by. You seem to be breaking up.
I can't hear you very well, Richard. I got a little interference here. What'd you say?
It's time to run. The rats are coming.
What? What do you mean the rats are coming? I don't see any rats down here.
No, I didn't say the rats were coming. That's the name of tonight's
What are you talking about, rats? I don't see any rats. I see him.
Randy, what's happening? Randy, you okay?
I got him.
Everything's okay. Everything's all right. I saw him. Thanks for the warning, Richard. Thanks a lot for the warning.
Hey, don't mention it. You know, anytime I can help. Well, anyway, time to roll tonight's epic feature. Now, if you can, try to sit through the first 20 minutes. You have to see the werewolves and that nasty sister, Monica. I mean, they make it well worth the wait. You know what I mean? Enjoy.
Hello, Monica, the little sister, the bitch.
Can she say that on TV?
She just did. Careful of the rats, because it really sounds like we got a problem down there, okay?
Not really. Not more than usual for this time of year.
I'm coming right up.
So, how do you like it so far, Dallas Fort Worth?
Pretty cheesy, huh? You know, the thing that's bugging me is how come these newlyweds didn't check into their background before they got hitched? Now, I ask you, ladies, would you marry a guy whose father was hung in public and rotted right away right there? And I ask you, you guys, would you marry a lady whose brother howled at the moon? I mean, these are important questions for such trying times.
Filmmaking from the Texas 27 Film Vault. You know what my favorite scene is tonight?
No, what is it?
I'll tell you, Monica and her rubber rat.
Me too. Let's look at that scene again.
I think I'll call you Ben. Benjamin. Do you like that name? That's a good name for you. What?
Yep, that is definitely a rubber rat. You know, I guess she wanted extra pay to play the scene with a real rat. That must have been the reason.
Oh, those actor types.
Oh.
I tell you. Hey, I like that scene with Mr. Macabre getting his legs eaten off by the same rats that he sold Monica.
You sell faulty rats, you pay the price.
Yeah, I guess it was kind of a form of early consumer protection.
Must have been.
It's time once again now for the secret coded message that we've been running all month long that you can win a waterbed with
you
if you've got a Film Vault secret decoder.
That's right.
Let's run that message one more time.
Right. Now, if you don't have a secret decoder, we want you to do us a favor. Why don't you send us a self-addressed stamped envelope to 433 Regal Row to the Texas 27 Film Vault, to Dallas, Texas 75247, or you cannot listen to me at all and just read what's coming up here on the screen, and we will send you a secret decoder, then you can figure out the message, and you're going to win a waterbed. I feel it in my bones.
Plus, growing a beard, he thinks he's cool.
Hey,
notice that? Look at this.
Rebecca!
Back with more of The Rats Are Coming, The Werewolves Are Here in just a moment.
It's almost gone. It's destroyed.
In conclusion to The Rats Are Coming, The Werewolves Are Here. Now, I want you to keep your eyes peeled for the werewolf makeup, okay? This is classic stuff.
Great stuff.
Lovely.
Lots
of funny dates, too. But you have to be very careful
when you Christmas Eve, you
know, because when they grow up,
they're
not thankful. Well, is it over or what?
I guess so.
Is it over?
Fine, good.
Okay, great. I guess the filmmakers ran out of money and couldn't afford any ending credits.
Or even a VN sign or into something like that.
Now listen, all you young hopeful filmmakers out there, this should give you encouragement.
Mm-hmm.
If rats can be made, you can make anything.
That's right. Now next week, what are we showing?
We're going to be showing Invisible Ghosts.
Yeah, and hopefully it'll be more palatable than this one.
Yeah, we're not going to have any more films with mice being tortured. Yeah. But I've had it with mouse snuff flicks.
That's right.
So until then, safety first.
Yeah, take that from me.
Okay.
So what do we do now?
Pick our noses. I don't know.
You're not supposed to say that, aren't you?
I can't say that.
No, you can't say that. We're supposed to say something like, well, old
yeah, that's right, we are.
Well, maybe we better just do what we normally do.
Hey, how about
a snack?
The long desire to dance queen could catch it all night long. But when I'm riding that wing, just for you, I'm in this way. And when I'm riding on that wing, my heart does start to sing.
Technicians out there.
Sit tight, serial fans. We've got Chapter 1 of Radar Men from the Moon, starring Commando Cody.
Fire main jet.
And our feature is a real knockout, if you know what I mean, the setup with Robert Ryan. And we will announce the
the winner of our Film Vault Technician Essay Contest.
He'll be here Saturday night at the Texas 27 Film Vault, 10:30, okay?
No problem here. The bite radius on this piece of film, these are small rats. Nothing to worry about.
Are you sure about that?
Yeah.
Well,
come on in. Come back up here.
Okay, well, you know, I noticed this problem earlier, and I was going to say something, but I don't need no trouble in the vault. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I understand.
Okay.
Hey, oh, look.
Hey, Dallas, where's this here?
You always creep up on us,
don't
you? Welcome to the Film Vault. I'm Randy Richard.
Yeah.
And we were looking over some film that we found on the lower levels. Apparently, we have a little rat problem again.
Rat problem.
Nothing to worry about. Not like last November.
Hey, we're two brave guys. You know, we can handle it.
No problem. These are little rats.
Oh, my God.
The big ones, the big mutant rats are all gone. But as you know, rats are a constant problem in the Film Vault all over the country. And,
and all the vaults.
That's why, of course, we're heavily armed.
Yeah, of course.
And, hey, we got a great movie tonight. We've got The Setup.
The
boxing movie.
Boom.
About a washed-up boxer that refuses to go crooked.
Yeah, that kind of
right.
Funny guy.
That's right.
Is this where you're showing Radar Man from the Moon?
What did you say?
The Radar Man from the Moon!
Oh, he wants to know if we're showing Radar Man from the Moon. That's right.
Yeah, we're showing Radar Man from the Moon tonight. That's chapter one of our brand-new serial. I was getting to that. Yeah.
The fans are coming out of the woodwork.
I got the popcorn in here.
I bet you do.
You want to watch Radar Man from the Moon here at the vault?
Yeah.
You want to watch it?
That's where I bought my hat.
Oh, you're...
Yeah, okay. We'll authorize it. Go on in.
Yeah, sit over there. You just take care. Watch out for the rats, though, okay?
Yeah, see. The fans...
Oh, you must have hit a rat.
The fans come out of the woodwork for Radar Men from the Moon.
They certainly do.
Let's watch chapter one of this brand-new exciting serial, followed by...
The Setup.
Very good.
Okay.
Roll it.
Laurie Moore can stay down to the bottom level, okay? Would you take care of that?
No.
No, what? Why? We're rats. You have to go.
I don't like rats.
You gotta go.
I don't
care. You don't have a gun. Take the gun.
Thanks.
These new recruits, I tell you. Cute, though.
Hey, Richard.
Yes.
Time now,
yes.
Almost.
Almost for what?
We're coming down to the final moment for the setup.
The
nice boxing spectacular. I love boxing movies,
Randy.
Dun, 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 dun.
I don't want to blow your cool here, but what is this in my chair?
Oh, that, yeah. I was hoping you'd like this.
I like it.
Since we're showing a boxing movie tonight, I went out and I got some Rock'em Sock'em Robot.
I don't believe this. I don't believe this.
Didn't you ever play with these when you were a kid?
Randy, I am not a kid anymore. I look like a kid.
Come on, you want to play this. I know you do.
I do not want to play it.
Yes, you do.
I do.
Yes, you do. Yes, you do.
Okay, I'll play.
Come on. All right. Okay. I get the red guy, you get the gray guy.
Are we going to go to the movie?
No, we're going to go to a break and be right back with
the
setup in just a moment. All right?
Okay.
Watch this.
Okay.
It's not my block off.
I get it.
Yeah, you're right.
It's a setup.
And there's some blood dripping from his opponent's eye. And he's going in for the
throw. I don't know, Gil.
Oh,
come on, Rushy, you can do it. Feeling strong.
All over. It's all... That's all over. I win once again, Ricardo.
This is a setup. That's all I got to say.
Well, tonight's movie is The Setup.
It's a great
oddly
one.
Enough.
Yeah.
How'd you like that little lead in there? Tonight's motion picture stars Robert Ryan and Audrey Totter. It's about a gutsy, washed-up boxer who refuses to give in to the mob.
That's so exciting. Who is it directed by? Oh,
hey,
great,
it was
one of
directed by Robert Wise, who also directed, he directed hundreds of films.
Like what?
Well, Sound of Music.
Oh, well, that's not a
box office smash of all time, and The Haunting.
The Haunting.
The Day the Earth Stood Still.
Oh, these are all great films.
Star Trek, the motion picture.
I don't believe it.
The Hindenburg. He did The Hindenburg.
The Hindenburg.
I knew I'd remember that one.
Oh,
you
boy.
Bet. Did you know, it's really odd, that tonight's film, released in 1949.
Yes, released. Yeah.
Was actually inspired by a poem by Joseph Moncure March.
Who is he?
I have no idea. But let's watch tonight's film.
Well, that's inspiring.
The Setup.
The Setup.
Roll it!
Richard, this is so stupid. Come on, this is
juvenile.
This
is not stupid. It's kind
of special. I've got other things to do.
Look, I know you're a busy man, but this is real special of all. Now, come on,
okay.
Now, don't
look,
peek.
Listen, I know I said you could have a pet, but can I just see them?
No, not until we get up here. I want to do it my way.
It's a poodle. I knew it. You went out and got a poodle with a little painted
toenail. No, I wouldn't get a poodle. Now, watch your step and
okay,
keep
well,
quiet.
It's a cat.
Oh, no, no, no. It's not a cat.
Okay.
It's not a cat. Now, just don't peek and be quiet. Now, this is a special moment.
A gerbil,
No, well, it's not exactly a gerbil. Just never mind. Now, you got your eyes closed.
Yeah, my eyes are closed. Can you get this over with? I want to see the...
Okay, we're going to watch She-Demons. Hang on. No, just don't look yet. Okay,
right.
Now, I don't want to do this right. Okay. Randy, meet Bob the Gorilla, my pet for the film vault, and he's my friend.
What do you think? I knew you'd love him.
Hi, everybody. I'm Bob Eubanks reminding you, be sure and watch the film vault every...
Saturday.
When?
Saturday night, 10:30.
Hey. Be sure and watch the Film Vault every Saturday night right here on Channel 28. 27. Saturday nights.
Right. Very good, Bob.
Thank you.
Oh, brother.
Bob.
Heel.
Bob. No, Bob.
No,
Bob.
Would you go if you look like this?
Fair, you have it. Another fine feature right here on the Texas 27 Film Vault. She demons, boy. Randy, I gotta tell you something. Thanks for letting me have a pet. This is Bob and Rilla, my pet. He's great. He's
I'm
really great. Don't you love
it? I'm having a nervous breakdown. I really.
Oh, Randy, come on. Have a heart. This is our pet. This is the mascot of the film.
I'm
going to
lose it right here in the air.
Bob the gorilla.
I'm going to right in front of all you. I'm going to go totally
stark raving. Oh, would you
shut up
for a minute? You're acting ridiculous.
You know, why can't you get a little dog? Why? I like little dogs. Little dogs, they sit up, you know, and all that stuff. I mean, why a gorilla?
Bob the gorilla can do lots of neat tricks.
Yeah, he destroyed the vault a while ago.
Well,
Richard,
don't worry about it.
Only you could come up with this kind of stuff.
Oh, enough of this garbage. Anyway, next week we're showing a great film, Assassin of Youth. And we're going to show you the scenes of our appearance at the Medallion Theater with the Q102 crew and the prizes we gave away. And hey, you never know, maybe Bob the Gorilla will be there too. I know Commando Cody's going to be there.
Yeah.
We're going to have lots of fun. It's just going to be a terrific time, ain't it, Randy?
Yeah, Ray. Where's he going to sleep, by the way?
He's going to sleep with you in your compartment. But anyway, like I was saying, at the Medallion Theater, oh, it was great. And you're going to enjoy the film. In your compartment, is that okay?
Safety first.
Safety first!
See you next week.
See you next week.
No, it's not safety in my compartment.